Who participates in the merit-based incentive payment system? I'm Molly MacHarris with CCSQ, and I will be leading you through this discussion. So who is eligible to participate under the MIPS program? Those clinicians that are eligible include physicians, physician assistants, nurse practitioners, clinical nurse specialists, and certified registered nurse anesthetists. Please note that when we talk about physicians here at Medicare, we mean not only MDs and DOs, but we also mean dentists, podiatrists, and optometrists. Additionally, we have certain levels of exclusions under the MIPS program. The first exclusion that everyone should be aware of is that if a clinician bills more than $30,000 annually and provides care for more than 100 patients, they are eligible to participate in the MIPS program. There are some additional exclusions that we have available under the MIPS program, which include clinicians who are newly enrolled in Medicare. So if the very first time you become enrolled in Medicare, if that's during 2017, which is the initial performance period, you are not eligible to participate in MIPS. You would, however, be eligible to participate in a future year. The third exclusion on the slide on the right-hand side deals with significant participation in advanced APMs. We have more information on how to meet this exclusion under other training modules which will be offered. So I would encourage folks to take a look at the training modules that deal with participation through APMs. And then the middle exclusion I touched on just a little bit earlier, which is the low volume threshold. I do want to note something here, which deals with the 30,000 or 100 patients. And you'll recall from the previous slide, it listed 30,000 and 100 patients. And I think if we advance to the next slide, there is an example for this. So the example is, I would like to know whether I'm exempt from the MIPS if I exceed either the physician fee schedule charges or beneficiary count, but not both. So we wanted to be really clear to everyone on exactly how this will work, because I can understand why it can be confusing, where in some instances we say that these two elements either or have to be met, but then in some instances they both have to be met. And it gets into a bit of a double negative, so I apologize in advance. But the way that it works is that when you're talking about who is eligible to participate, meaning from the positive end, it's an and, meaning clinicians would need to have 30,000 in billing and see more than 100 patients. When you talk about it from the negative end, however, meaning from who is excluded, it's an or. So clinicians are excluded if they see less than or equal to 30,000 or less than or equal to 100 patients. And we have an example on the slide here that provides a scenario where a clinician would be exempt. So their billing is 29,000 and they see 101 patients, so then they would be exempt. There are a couple additional eligibility scenarios that all eligible clinicians should be aware of. An additional eligibility scenario deals with those clinicians who are considered to be non-patient facing. Non-patient facing clinicians are typically pathologists and certain types of radiologists. There also are a few other specialties as well. Non-patient facing clinicians are eligible to participate under the MIPS program. In some instances, however, they have different scoring rules that would be applied under some of the performance categories. Thank you for viewing this presentation. For more information, please visit the Quality Payment Program website at qpp.cms.gov.